गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। We are meeting again in this semester. How are you all?
I'm fine, ma'am.
You're good?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, Ravi's thumbs up is here. So, good to see you all. How was the exams? Everything went off well?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Yes, ma'am. Good. Okay, so we are now, you all are in the second semester. Okay, so this will be your business communication class, as it happened in the last class. Last semester, we had two classes per week or one class per week?
Ma'am, in the starting we have one classes per week, but at the last moment we have two or three classes per week.
Na beta, was that one credit course or two credit course?
Ma'am, in first semester we have two classes in a week.
In a week, oh, so similarly this time also you'll have two classes per week, which means 27 classes in our hand. Yes. And the course will be a little different. I'll just share it with you, give me a second, so that you know that these are the things that we will go ahead this semester. Can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so this will be your this will be your course for this semester. Module number one will be writing process, workplace communication, which will have memos, letters, circulars, agenda. And then second module will have the reports and proposal, which is slightly typical. Okay, obviously you all in the second semester, things will not be that easy as it was in the first semester. Cross-cultural communication will be there in module number 3. Module number 4, persuasive communication. 5, professional etiquette. 6, career skills. So these will be a part of your course module. And the same course I am going ahead with my another class of BCom honors. So the course will remain the same. Let's begin. Oh, let me share the screen. What was there in the last semester? Anyone remember? Remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Kya tha? What did we do in the last class?
Ma'am.
Little different from what we are doing today?
Yes, ma'am. Little bit different.
Different, hai na? ये ज़्यादा आपका टेक्निकल बेस्ड एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंक्लाइंड है. वेट, आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू शेयर द स्क्रीन विद यू सो दैट वी कैन स्टार्ट द मॉड्यूल. कोर्स कंटेंट इज हियर. Now I am taking BLED second semester, BLED fourth semester and sixth semester. All BLED even semesters are with me. Communication, we are doing it now. It's here. Wait, let the screen from? You all are in your hometown?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Takes time to open one file. Okay. Okay, here we go. Can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
So we'll discuss about some aspects of communication. So you know how it goes. There'll be somebody who's going to read it and I'll be evaluating, I'll be describing it, I'll be explaining the same, right? I don't want every line to be read, right? So whosoever is reading, I'll stop you and I probably might want to explain to you what is written here. As always, that thing that had happened in the last semester, I'll be uploading all the notes for you on MS Teams, right? So everything which I'm teaching from, these notes, these reference will all be shared with you all, right? So you don't have to worry about the content part, but obviously that does not mean that you are sitting empty hands. Please sit with a notepad and pen, and whatever you feel is important and that is something that you wish to make a note of it, please do that. Okay? Did you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. It says bad network quality. If the sound quality is bad, check your internet. Is the sound quality bad? Can you all listen to what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
So who's going to read it? Vidhi, shall we start it with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'll keep stopping you in between. Don't get disturbed.
Okay, ma'am. Start, ma'am.
Start reading. Start.
Communication is simply the act of transforming information from one place, person, or group to another. Every communication involves at least one sender, a message, and a receipt. This may sound simple, but communication is actually a very complex subject. The transmission of the message from sender to receipt can be affected by a huge... can be affected by a huge range of things. These includes our emotions, the cultural situations, the mediums used to communicate, and even our location. The complexity is why good communication skills are considered so desirable by employers around the world. Accurate, effective, and unambiguous communication is extremely hard.
As this definition, okay, I'll tell you. And Vidhi, I'll ask you to read in a while, right? So when we're talking about communication, students, it is important for us to know that communication is basically a procedure we are talking about, a formal communication wherein one person speaks to the other person and one conversation is being communicated to the other person. And when we're talking about communication, it says that somebody who's speaking is transmitting the idea, is giving the idea to the another person. the recipient, right? So this may, it sounds very simple, but it has various catches in between, which is why it says it's a complex subject. So when you transmit a message from one person to another and another person absorbs the same and reacts accordingly, the whole chain and whole process is called the communication process, which is why the complexity is why good communication skills are considered so desirable. One second. Yeah, so we are talking about the message that is being transmitted from one person to another, and a very good communication skills are considered desirable by employers around the world. You know, there are people who are looking for a candidate whose communication skills are clear, whose communication skills are accurate. There should be a lot of clarity. See, communication is not only about two people speaking and no one understands what the other person is saying. But communication is all about when two people communicate, there should be a lot of clarity, there should be a lot of transparency, there should be a lot of smoothness in the communication should be there. There should not be anything that is hidden. So yehi sari quality hoti hai a good communicator ki. Okay. And communication is not only about talking to two people. It's about when you share the ideas, when you share the opinion, when you give each other some kind of information. So this is what, it's a channel. You say something, I say something to you. So that's a communication channel wherein lot of clarity and lot of, there should not be any kind of misinterpretation. There should not be any kind of miscommunication. And the process should be very smooth and clear. Okay, so there are three parts. The communication is basically divided in three parts: the sender, the message, and recipient. Okay, please, beta, nahi samajh mein aaye, stop me then and there. Ravi, Alisha, Alia.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, you all know how I teach. है ना, जो नहीं आएगा, बिकॉज आई कांट सी यू ऑल राइट नाउ, आई अज्यूम कि सबको सब समझ में आ रहा है. लेट मी नो द मोमेंट यू फील आई एम गोइंग टू फास्ट, प्लीज स्टॉप मी. ठीक है, आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम, आई एम नॉट इन अ हरी. ओके, नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट कम्युनिकेशन, इट इज बीइंग, ओके, कैन यू सी द स्क्रीन? इट हैज गॉन सडनली. Okay, you all can. Yes, right, so when we talk about communication, it is being divided into three part. The sender, jab hum baat karte hai, so I am sending a message to you. So the message is something that I am sending it to you, and you are the recipient. Aap absorb kar rahe ho mere message ko. You are understanding what I am saying. So this procedure is called the communication procedure, and that is how it kind of evolves, and that is how there's a chain. I say something, so I have communicated, so I am the sender, you are the recipient to receive it, and whatever communication, whatever I'm communicating it to you is the message. Now you go to another person and communicate the same thing, to wo aap sender hoge and the another person will be the recipient. Right, so it is not very complex procedure, but yes, at times it is said that the complexity of communication means that each one may receive a slightly different message. Wo Chinese what do you call that, whisper game khela hai aap logo ne life mein apne kabhi? You remember Chinese whisper?
No ma'am.
Nahin? जब हम एक के कान में कुछ बोलते हैं, आई टेल यू अ सेंटेंस, राइट, एंड देन आई आस्क यू टू स्पीक द सेम सेंटेंस टू समबडी एल्स, यू विस्पर एंड स्पीक द सेंटेंस. नो वन हैज प्लेड दिस गेम एवर, डोंट टेल मी.
मैम लाइक मूवीज नेम,
मूवी नेम नहीं, सेंटेंस की बात होती है.
दे गिव एनी टॉपिक लाइक एनी फ्रूट नेम और एनीथिंग. And we have to whisper in a group.
Then we Shreya, fruit name to pata chal jayega beta. I say apple to you. इट्स अ सेंटेंस, इट्स अ स्टेटमेंट.
तो एक दो वर्ड्स मिस हो जाते हैं.
दिस इज व्हाट इट इज ऑल अबाउट. यही दिस इज व्हाट प्रिसाइसली इट इज सेइंग. सी व्हेन वी आर कम्युनिकेटिंग एनीथिंग देयर आर टाइम्स व्हेन द वर्ड्स गेट मिस्ड, व्हेन द इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ द मैसेज goes down. Because if I am communicating something to you and if it's a channel, so the tendency is that you never know, whatever information I wish to convey to you, you might not get the same information. So there is a complexity. This is what they're talking about, right? Two people may read very different things into choice of the words or the body language. If I say something to Ravi, right, Ravi understands it, okay, ma'am, you know, ma'am does not want to say this to me, but she is saying this, this is her intention. But somebody thinks that ma'am intentions is not this, ma'am intention is something else, right? So two people perceiving the same communication in two way is what they are talking about, right? So it there are chances, which is why it is said thoda complex hota hai, because if there is no clarity, if the tone, if the voice, if the words, if the pitch, if the choice of the sentence or the words is wrong, then your one message can be taken to the another level altogether. So which is why kehte hai ki thoda complex hota hai if there is no clarity between two people or the message is not very clear. Theek hai? Now we divide the categories of communication into various parts. Let's see. Spoken and verbal communication. राइट अभी तो हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, वर्बली कम्युनिकेशन तो कर रहे हैं. आई एम स्पीकिंग समथिंग टू यू, यू आर सिंपली लिसनिंग टू व्हाट आई एम स्पीकिंग. द मोमेंट यू स्टार्ट रिस्पोंडिंग, आई एम गोइंग टू लिसन इट टू यू, राइट? सो इट्स अ फेस टू फेस वर्चुअल प्लेटफॉर्म, बट इट्स अ फेस टू फेस कम्युनिकेशन हैपनिंग बिटवीन यू एंड मी, विच इज अ वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन. Non-verbal communication, if I don't say anything and I keep on observing you, right? You are giving a presentation, you're using your hand movement, you're using giving a lot of facial expressions. So many things are happening, the way you are standing, the way you're performing, the way you are talking, the kind of gestures you are reflecting, the tone. So I am judging you on different parameters. I'm not judging on the verbal expression of yours. I am judging on the parameters of your body language. So this is a non-verbal communication on which we judge anyone. Which is why we say ki hand cross karke mat khade ho. Agar hand cross karke khade hoge, so it gives an impression that you are very arrogant. So probably these are the things that usually people do face. Samajh mein aa raha hai, Alisha, Alia, anything
yes.
You don't understand, please stop me. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Alia. Alia.
Ma'am, Alia is facing some network issue. That's why she is rejoining.
Now there is something called the written communication. Written communication, we all know, anything, any proposal, any project, any application, letter, memo, notice, anything, emails, right? So these are the written communication, and we always say ki communication does not mean that when you talk to people. Communication also happens when you write something. If I'm very agitated, if I'm very annoyed, and if I want to send a message to my colleagues saying this is something I did not like, toh hum kya karte hai? When we write a message, even on the chat, on the WhatsApp, in the group, when we write a message, something that I want everyone to pay attention, तो हम उसको block में लिखते हैं, block letters पे, and we highlight that. When we highlight the message, when we write it in block letters, it automatically gives the impression to the other person that you are saying something which is very loud. Okay, so which is why even in the written communication, anyone can gauge, anyone can make out whether you are angry or not. Okay. बेटा प्लीज हाँ हाँ बोलते रहो, वरना मुझे लग रहा है कि कोई सुन नहीं रहा है. एंड आई एम गोइंग टू, यू नो हाउ आई एम, आई एम गोइंग टू आस्क यू क्वेश्चंस इन बिटवीन, है ना? ओके, कमिंग टू विजुअलाइजेशन. सेकंड रुको, लेट मी जस्ट टिल्ट माय चेयर अ लिटिल बिट. वन सेकंड. Okay, now I'm back. So as I was telling you that when we talk about the visualization in communication, what is visualization in communication? Visualization in communication means the signboards, the maps, or the slogan, or anything that does not speak, but that tells you that this is what it is all about, right? So this is called the visualization. What is written here? Let's see. Visualization means the graph, charts, maps, logos, and the other things that tells you about anything. Assume that there's a signboard that tells you that you have to go on the left hand side or the right hand side. So the signboard gives the direction on a right hand side. So signboard does not speak right chalo, right chalo. You automatically know if it is on the right hand side, you have to go on the right hand side. So this is how even the visuals speak. Right now, there are eight essential components of a communication. Let's see what are these eight essentials. Source, message, channel, receiver, feedback, environment, context, and interference. Now, source means where is this information coming from? Ye information aa kahan se rahi hai? Source kya hai? Television hai, magazine hai, internet hai, somebody said something. And I'm sure you must have realized in public speaking or in the presentation, there are times when somebody says something, wo hamesha bolte hai as quoted by this or as per International Labor Association or organization, right? So ye kya hota hai? Whenever we give our content, we give the reference, we tell the source ki ye information humko mili kahan se, right? So this is what the source is all about. It talks about that what exactly you have to say and how you are saying it, right? So that's the source of the information that you have it in you and how beautifully you are going ahead with that particular source is the beauty of any can. Source matlab ki kya aapka ye jo aapko speech deliver karni hai, ye kaun se source se aayi hai? Did you see somewhere else? Did you see here? Did you see there? Did you read it from somewhere? Or if it is about some facts and figures, then you quote the name of the website, then you quote the name of the journal or any author's name or anything like that. So that the people should know that whatever information you are sharing it with the audience is authentic enough. Okay, so this is source. Now coming to the message hai kya? Okay, what is a message? You remember when we are communicating, a public speaking ka hi example lete hain. Now I have the source, I have lot of content. Now the message that I am giving, the message that I am delivering to the other person should be in such a way so that the other person should get to know how genuine is the content. Agar main bahut important baat hans ke bolti hoon, so probably that conversation will lose its gravity. Aur agar koi bahut hansi ki baat main gusse mein bolti hoon, then probably people will never ever take you seriously. Right, that you probably crack jokes whenever it is not needed and you do not crack joke whenever it is needed, right? So the kind of message that you are conveying should have that kind of gravity. Also, the words are brought together with grammar and organization. You choose to save most important point for last. Aapke paas char messages hain convey karne ke liye. You said something, 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 something. And last mein, before you end your presentation or you end your conversation, you say something very important. So that jo so bhi rahe honge na, wo bhi uth jate, acha, this is very important. This is something related to me only, right? So it again depends upon the kind of message that you are sharing it with the other person, okay? Your tone of voice, your body language, your appearance, your punctuation way, your style, right? So it tells a lot about how well you are conveying the kind of message, right? Is it clear, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
It's clear.
अभी देखो ये लास्ट एग्जांपल कितना अच्छा लिखा हुआ है. नाउ दे हैव गिवन द एग्जांपल ऑफ अ वर्ल्ड सीरीज. अब यू गिव मी अ मैसेज, यू गिव मी अ लेक्चर, यू गिव मी अ सेशन ऑन World Cup, or you give me a session on cricket, and then you suddenly realize that I am not interested in cricket. I don't like sports, my cricket at all. So you need to understand what message are you giving it to what kind of person. Will this person be interested to listen to the message that I want to convey? Is what it is all about. Next karte hai channel. Channel means medium. Channel means the source of information is traveling from what source? What is the source? Is the source television? Is the source some kind of channel? Now, when we talk about source, you can still understand that what is happening. Many a times you can, because the body language conveys a part of a message of the show. Now turn up the volume of the turn around. Okay, this is all the television example, I'll tell you. Now when we talk about channel, channel means the source of information. Now at times what happens is I convey something to you. You don't want to listen to the things that I'm conveying it to you, right? But the channel is the medium. You have to listen what I am saying, right? So similarly TV pe hota hai na. You don't want to listen to some news, so you lower down the volume of the television. But even if you lower down the volume of the television, your eyes are watching that. And even so, you just remove your eyes from whatever the news is coming. But still some part, some aspect of the news or some aspect of the visual of that news will be, you will definitely be come across. So this is what it says, the channel. Right, so channel means how many channels do you have on a television? You have so many channels. Aap ek channel band karoge, dusra channel will come up. You close the second channel, the third channel will come up, right? So obviously, even in the digital world, the cable in the signal that brings the message each channel to your home. Television combines an audio signal and a visual signal, right? So the signal means, the television means, the channel means the information that is coming to you. Now it entirely depends upon you how well and what is the way that you are using that channel to yourself. Are you over utilizing it? Are you utilizing it? Are you overthinking it? Are you simply understanding it? Agar aapke interest ka hai to aap use absorb karte, interest ka nahi hai to usko band karte ho. So how well you are using that channel is entirely up to you. Right. So spoken channels include face-to-face conversations, speeches, telephone conversation, voicemail messages, radio. Right. So ye channels hi to hai. If I am not available, my message will come on the voicemail. Right. If I am not available, there is a system on the WhatsApp that you record your sound and send it across. Right. So obviously these are channels. Even I don't want to be a part of any conversation, you send it to me, I am bound to open. I am bound to open. Right. And obviously you can delete it also, but these are the medium, these are the sources, these are the channels by which one communication is being transmitted to the other person. Coming to the receiver. Receiver means I am somebody who is receiving all the information, right? If I am receiving all the information, it is entirely my responsibility of what to absorb and what not to absorb. Like it says, I have a dish in front of me and the dish is extremely tempting, right? And if I have a dish and the dish is tempting, it is entirely up to me whether I taste that dish or not, right? So similarly, it is entirely your responsibility. You may get to receive a lot of messages from all the corner. Now it is your duty what to absorb and what to ignore. So similarly, as your receiver, you listen, see, touch, smell, taste, right? And receive a message. Your audience sizes you up. Much as you might check them out long before you take the stage to open your mouth. Nonverbal responses of your listeners can serve you clues on how to adjust your opening. Imagining yourself in the place you anticipate, what would you look for if you were them, right? It's something that you must understand. Abhi thoda sa, it is it is something I will relate it with the spirituality here. People say that you might get the messages from everywhere. Ravi, are you here with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Alisha, Alia, Shreya, Shweta, Vidhi.
Yes, ma'am.
I am not looking anywhere on the screen. Still, I remember the names of everyone. Okay. Right?
Yes.
So this is what I was telling you, that when we talk about abhi receiver ko aap is tarike se samjho, that you as a person receives message from all the corner. Shweta ko Shreya bhi baat karti hai, Shweta se ye bhi baat karte hai, wo bhi baat karte hai, wo bhi baat karte hai, ghar pe bhi sab baat karte hai, friends bhi baat karte hai, relatives bhi baat karte hai. Now Shweta has lot of stuff in her head. Now it is your beauty to understand what to absorb. Kisi ne criticize kiya, kisi ne aisa bola, kisi ne waisa bola, kisi ne bahut acha bola, kisi ne bahut tareef kari, right? Now it is my duty, it is my responsibility to understand what should I absorb and what should I ignore, right? So similarly, when somebody says something to you, please bring yourself to their place. Had you been at their place, what would have you done? Kya aap kisi ko criticize karte hain? Agar karte bhi, it is their take. You have to understand that this is the brain and how much you can keep it, keep the things inside your brain. So it is entirely your way to handle such situation. So this is what receiver is all about. Coming to the feedback. Feedback kya hota hai? Feedback means if somebody is communicating something to you, it is said that there will be people who is going to give you their set of opinion. Aapko kai sare log kai sare opinions denge. Aisa karo, waisa karo, aisa nahi karo, waisa nahi karo. Aisa karte to things would have been better. Ab waisa karte to things have been extremely nice. So obviously there will be so many people giving you so many opinions, so many viewpoints. It is okay. Feedback does not mean everyone appreciating me and saying good things to me. No. Feedback is when somebody tells me, you could have improvised this, you could have improvised on that, rest you are good. Which means somebody is telling me my set of weakness and it is important for me to know my set of weakness. If I'll not get to know, I will never be able to improve. Hana? So this is what it says, that the amount of feedback increases, the accuracy of your communication will also increase. If somebody is saying something and the things are not clear, so you go and tell the person, dekho, abhi next time, na, whatever you tell me, make sure that you add this also and give me the correct information. If the information is not correct, please circulate mat karo. Right? So such kind of feedback will help the person ki wo aage se, he'll be very alert that this is the information I should not circulate if I don't have the complete info. Samajh mein aaya? So this is what feedback is all about. Now, coming to environment, bahut depend karta hai aapka communication environment mein. If I know that this place is full of managers, this place is full of professionals, this place is full of the corporates, big corporates or even the executives, and everyone is so professional. Can I afford to come in capri and t-shirts? Can you come in capri and t-shirts? You can't. Because then you know it is the formal gathering. I cannot come dressed up that way. Can you say hello, hi to everyone? No. You are bound to say good morning, good afternoon. Can you speak about the movies and the film stars or the fashion or can you speak about your personal life with them? Can you do that? No, because you know that's a professional forum and nothing personal will be entertained there. So this is what the environment is. So similarly, whatever you speak, howsoever you are speaking, you need to understand that these are the things I should speak and these are the things I should avoid. Ye hame baat karni chahiye, ye hame baat nahi karni chahiye. So this is what environment is all about, right? So kiss environment mein, how are you going to approach and how are you going to react will be something that you have to take care. Okay? Any doubts till now, please let me know.
No, ma'am. It's all clear.
No, ma'am. It's all clear, yes, ma'am.
Perfect. Now coming to context. Now context means हमने पता है what are the things that I'm going to speak. But context गलत है. Context means the way I'm discussing my things to you, my tone, my approach, you know, having a conversation with you. Right? So when you come to class, you come from somewhere. So did the person seated next to you? Did the instructor? The degree to which environment is formal and informal depends upon the contextual expectations of communication held by the participants. So what happens is you are talking to another person, but you have no idea what kind of mindset that the other person is sitting with. Somebody had a very bad day. And you come up and say, hello, hi, how are you? How's life? Did you see this movie? And the person turns back to you and says, like, not well today. So give me some time, right? So don't disturb me. Now, somebody is very happy, extremely happy, right? And somebody is very happy and you say, you can't expect everyone to be happy because you are happy today, right? So similarly, the kind of tone that you are using, the kind of context that you are talking to, the kind of background that you are coming from, the kind of language that you are using, the kind of topic that you are discussing on will depend a lot about the kind of individual you are, right? So similarly, you cannot be too casual with your teachers. On a professional forum, you can't be talking about the personal stuff of yours. So these are the basic things that you should keep in mind when when dealing with the professionalism or when dealing with the context. Okay, so it says context is all about what people expect from each other. I expect you to be a little mature. You expect me to be a little kiddish. I expect you to do this. You expect me to do this. This is what it is all about, right? So create those expectations out of the environmental clues, right? So traditional gatherings like weddings are often a formal events. It's time to quiet social gathering, time for silence as a bride walks down the aisle. Yeah. You don't have to worry about it. This is all very bookish examples given. I am coming to the next, that is interference. So what is interference? Interference is basically a noise that comes from any source. Interference in anything blocks the changes of source, intended meaning of the message. The basic of interpersonal communication, for example, if you drove a car to school, chances are that you are surrounded by noise, car horns, billboards, perhaps the radio in your car interrupted your thoughts or your conversation with the passenger. So interference, hum sabko pata hai, it happens and it is very natural. If I want to communicate it with you, I can have a lot of interferences, the physical interference also. When somebody comes and says, so pehle mujhe ye batao, uske baad you go and have a talk with the person. So there is a kind of interference wherein somebody else came and stopped me approaching you. So this is another kind of interference. Aur kya kya ho sakta interference mein? That thinking something very deeply that I want to communicate this and somebody is continuously hammering on your head, you know, dhar, 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 dhar. So again, there's a kind of interference that comes up. So when we talk about interference, it is all about this. You may open an email and start to read and think, great, no problem, I have no figures analysis right now in the computer. Okay. It's all bookish. You all understood interference, no? Something like this comes, you all know what it is, no? Okay, interference can come from other sources also. Perhaps you are hungry and your attention to your current situation interferes with the ability to listen. Maybe off the office is hot, stuffy. If you were a number of audience listening to an executive speech, how could this impact your ability to listen and participate? Okay. Now, the interference can happen with the help with the sound also. You know, you're working on your system. There's something very important and there's a sound which is constantly coming. This is again a kind of interference that might come. Noise interference with normal encoding and decoding the message, right, carried by the channel between the source and the receiver. Yeah, so it is all about this. Even the ringtone of a cell phone is a kind of interference. Is it clear, everyone? Anyone has any doubts, please ask. I don't want to just continue the class just like that. I know you all are listening, but I don't want you all to simply doing something else and having the earphone on. Samajh aaya, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Chale.
Yes, ma'am.
It is, yes. Okay. Achha. It is 4 o'clock. I'll meet you all correct after 12 minutes. Take care. Okay, ma'am. I'll meet you after 12 minutes. It's 4 o'clock. I'll meet you all at 4:12. Okay. Take a break and we'll meet at 4:12.
Okay, ma'am.
Shall we begin?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you all here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
What did you do in this break? Vidhi, Ravi?
Yes, ma'am.
Is Alia back?
I think, ma'am.
Are, Ravi, you're sleeping, which means you're sleeping. I am not taking even attendance. Huh? I am not taking attendance. Why are you saying present? Shraddha?
Yes, ma'am.
What did you do in this break? 12 minutes break. What did you do?
Nothing, ma'am. I'm actually here.
You're sleeping?
No.
Hmm.
Using phone.
Okay, phone. Phone is the best friend, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Phone is everyone's best friend these days. What is the news of Alia, Shweta? Are you still the CR of the class or we have a different CR this time?
Ma'am, still me and Shreya.
Not happy?
Yes, ma'am.
Not happy?
Ma'am, I'm happy.
Okay. Any news of Alia?
Yes, ma'am, she's joined.
She's on hold.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So let's begin where we stopped. Where did we stop? We stopped somewhere. Let me open the file. Oh, you all can see the file, no? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we'll talk about the basic communication process. Vidhi, you want to read? And after Vidhi, Shraddha will read.
Communication process. Can I start?
Process. Don't say process, say process. Say process.
Okay, ma'am.
Say?
Ma'am, it's process.
Absolutely. Go ahead.
Communications is a continuous process which mainly involves three elements, sender, message, and receiver. The elements involved in the communication process are explained below in details. Sender. The sender or the communicator generates the message and convey into the receiver. He is the source and the one who starts the communication. Second,
absolutely.
Message.
You all understood, no? Sender means somebody who sends the message. If I have to give a sender message to Shreya, saying that Shreya, tomorrow is a test. So I am the sender, Shreya is the receiver, and the message is that tomorrow is a test. But tomorrow is no test. It's just an example. Message.
It is the idea, information, view, fact, feeling that is generated by the sender and is then intended to be communicated further.
Right. And so how Shreya, but let me just, you all understand that, do you need explanation in this?
No, ma'am.
Then read.
No, ma'am.
In coding, the message generated by the sender is encoded symbolically, such as in the form of words, pictures, textures, etc., before it is being conveyed.
Right. So if I tell Shreya, tell everyone that tomorrow is a class test. So Shreya will imagine, for once she will imagine communication test. Everyone is sitting, writing. Did I prepare myself? No, I did not prepare. I have to study this, I have to study that. And such are the things that Shreya will have, you know, instantly she will think about whatever I have communicated to her, right? And then she will change, not change exactly, and then she will decide that this is the information I need to communicate it to the rest of my friends. So first her mind will visualize the things, and after visualizing she'll convey the same to the other person. This is called encoding. Yes. What is next? Yeah. What happened? Read.
Okay, ma'am. It is the manner in which encoded message is transmitted. The message may be transmitted orally or in writing. The media of communication includes telephone, internet, post, fax, email, etc. The choice of media is decided by the sender.
Okay, I may send this information to Shreya via WhatsApp, via email, it could be face to face also, whichever way, that's the media that I choose. And the medium is something that I will choose to tell her, and then she will choose to communicate it to the rest. Yeah.
Okay. Decoding. It is the process of converting the symbols encoded by the sender. After decoding, the message is received by the receiver.
Okay. Now, the moment I sent a message to Shreya, Shreya tell everyone that tomorrow is a class test, right? So Shreya visualizing class test, communication, modules, preparedness, non-preparedness, everyone writing the exam. And she is contemplating in her mind that tomorrow is the test. Now, when she communicates the same to the rest of the students, then she is decoding the statement. And the process of converting the symbols encoded by the sender, jo humne bheja tha, usko encode kara. After decoding the sender, after decoding the message is received by the receiver. Jab tak wo aage communicate karegi, everyone will absorb. That is called the decoding. I evolved the thought. She encoded it. You got the message, you decoded it. Okay, understood?
Yes, ma'am, understood, ma'am.
Okay, next.
Receiver. He is the person who is last in the chain and for whom the message was sent by the sender. Once the receiver receives the message and understands it is in proper perspectives and acts according to the message, only the purpose of communication is successful.
Okay, so this is the receiver. Okay, we've already discussed this, so it is all, you all know.
Feedback. Once the receiver confirmed to the senders that he has received the message and understood it, the process of communication is complete.
Okay, perfect. Noise.
It refers to an obstruction that is caused by the sender, message or receiver during the process of communication. For example, bad telephone connections, frequent encoding, frequent decoding,
faulty
encoding, faulty decoding. Ma'am,
encoding and faulty decoding, inattentive receiver. Right? So noise matlab kya hua? Noise matlab koi bhi tarike ka obstruction. That my phone rings, somebody comes to meet me, somebody is saying something else to you, there's a music playing at the background, you are thinking something else, the network connection is not there, you say something I did not understand, I conveyed something to somebody else did not understand. So these are the obstructions that might create, but that might come up when you are in a process of communication. Okay. एंड देखो कितना अच्छा लिखा है, नॉइस में देर आर थ्री एरोज, दैट इज गोइंग टू मैसेज, दैट इज गोइंग टू चैनल, दैट इज गोइंग टू द रिसीवर. बेसिकली दीज आर द थिंग्स वेयर द नॉइस मेजरली गेट्स अफेक्टेड. When the message is being transmitted, when there is a channel, the kind of channel that you have decided to be, and the kind of receiver who is receiving the information, the noises वगैरह, the obstruction will majorly hamper there. Okay. Okay. Barriers to communication, I don't think it is there. Give me a second. Barriers to communication, psychological. I don't think barriers are there. Still, I'll check in the syllabus so that there is no confusion. No, barriers is not here, so I am not continuing with this. I'll share another screen with you. Anyone has any doubt till now, please ask.
No, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Is Alia back?
No, ma'am, she's on hold.
One second, the file is taking long to open. Okay, now it is here. We have done this concept. Okay, there's lot on communication. I have to find it out that what are the things needed in this communication. So which is why I want to open all the files and see. Lot of communication modules, lot of communication. As per syllabus, you are not required to know about all these details. Okay. So what we'll do is we'll leave this part here and we'll continue with, I'll streamline this even more, the module number one, which has letters, notices, memo, circulars are here. They are here, so let me just share it with you all. Okay. This communication, I will take only what is needed. This is not needed. Let me know if it is visible. Shweta and Shreya, either of you, right? You have the syllabus on Amazon, right? Amazon, yes, you'll find the syllabus. Take that syllabus printout, keep it with you, right? And the things that we have done, keep highlighting that, right? So I might pick up the module randomly, but I want you to keep a track of everything.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So aaj we did the basic concept of communication.
Ma'am, you are not audible.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, now.
Okay, we have done the overview of communication today. And now we are going to do the notice formats and memos. Okay?
Okay.
I am keeping a record of everything, but I want you also to have everything with you. Okay. Now, we'll talk about notices. Notices hai na syllabus mein. We have notices here, right? So when we're talking about notices kya hote? Notices, okay, who's going to read it quickly? Shraddha, read.
Yes, ma'am.
You only read it earlier.
Ma'am, jo so ra hai isme? Circular.
Nee. Huh? Who read it? Vidhi read it or you read it?
2000. Vidhi.
Vidhi read it. Not. Okay. Now you read. Notices. Read.
A particular person or a group of persons. It is like a news item informing such person or persons of the important event. This can be an event invitation to a meeting, an announcement of an event to issues, current instructions make appears, etc. It is generally written and then displayed at a public place. There it is accessible to all. They can be placed to the notice board. If it is made for a valid announcement, audition, it can even be published in a newspaper or government when it issues notice, much published in national and local paper.
Okay, so when we talk about notices means the information which is being circulated, the news which is being circulated, right? It's like a news item informing such person or probably about some event. Abhi hota nahi hai, you remember? If there is some event organizing in one department, so the notice goes to the other department to please send your students for the participation. So that is what notice is all about. It's a kind of invitation to a meeting, for any kind of event, for any kind of announcement. So that is called notice, right? And in the notice, there are certain instructions well written. Kuch instructions hote hain that all right, you have to come formally dressed, or this is the time, this is the thing that you have to come along with. So these are the basic instructions that is being written in the notices. And notice is always called as one of the Yeah, and the notices are also called that one of the aspects wherein it's a written communication. It is called the official document, right? So everything that is written in the notice is considered to be very serious. Okay, so it is generally written. Notice hamesha likha hi jata, it's a written only, and usually it is being displayed in the public places where you know it is accessible to all. You must have seen in the colleges, in the schools, ek notice board hua karta tha hum logo ka, right? So notice board pe your principal, your teachers, your coordinators used to put the notices. So it is expected that everyone who will pass the corridor will see what is there on the notice. So it is not to be given personally to everyone, but it is to be put and it is accessible to everyone to see. Take care. It is meant for the wider audience. It can be published in the newspaper. Notices can be published in the newspaper, especially government. Government ki notices jo hoti hai, anything, any implementation of any law, any job application or anything like that, it is usually being published in the newspaper, right? It happens usually of government notices. Okay, is it clear, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then is memos. Formats nahi hai. Okay. What is memo? Okay. Shreya, do you want to read? Shweta, do you want to read?
Yes, ma'am. I'm reading. What is a memo? A memo is actually short form of memorandum. It is one of the most used means of official communication in the business world. It is a main purpose to serve as a reminder or to give some instructions. Again, these like circulars are a means of mass communication as to communicate with a large number of people within the organization. Usually, we write a memo is for one of the following five reasons. As a reminder, highlight an event or circumstance, to recount an event, keep an official record of anything, to pass information of instructions. Memos have been a popular way for communicating for century now. This is because they have many advantages as seen below. They are a very
okay. Let me explain till here. Now, what are memos? Memos are basically the memorandums. Kaise hote hai memorandums? Memorandums are this postcard. Dekha hai, jo pehle postcard chalte the? Those postcards? Remember?
Yes.
So memorandums are like those postcards only, and it is usually being circulated from one department to another department, and it is strictly a official way to communicate, right? So memorandums are official way to communicate. It's a formal communication from one department to another department, from one office to another office. So what is the main purpose of the memorandum? Basically, it is a kind it is to be used to give the reminders, to give some kind of instructions, and now when you write the things in the memorandum, it is not for the complete department. It is for one person, as in the senior authority of that person, and let the senior authority circulate the same information to everyone. Notices सबके लिए लगी होती है. Memorandum सबके पास नहीं जाएगा, right? Memorandum will come go to one person, and that one person will circulate the memorandum to everyone. Ki read it, what is there, and again it will come back and it will be punched in the file. ठीक है? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, why do we write? And what are the reasons for, you know, preparing a memorandum? Kyun banate hain memorandum? Basically, memorandum are being prepared as a reminder for any event, highlight of any event, recount of an event, ki kya kya raha, kya kya the data tha and everything. Official record of anything, that this is a new file that we are making, or this is the new record that we have, right? Or to pass any kind of information or instruction. If something else is happening in my department, I want all the departments to know about it. So for that also we can use memorandums or any kind of instructions that somebody wish to give it to somebody else. So for that we use the memorandums. Yeah, what is next, Shweta?
Yes, ma'am. Memos have been a popular way for communicating for over a century now. This is because they have many advantages as seen below. They are a very cost-effective way of mass communication and their transmission is also very cheap. Another advantage is its simplicity. They are very simple to write and understand. Memos tend to be brief and to the point. They also reach a lot of people, so they are very time saving as well. They are also served as evidence in case of a dispute.
Right?
Yes, from dispute.
So Shweta read it for us, that when we talk about memorandums are very cheap. It is just a postcard sized thing and very cost effective, and it is considered as the official document. So the evidence is kept in the departments or in the offices that this has been communicated at this time, at this date, right? So obviously that's the official record, and it is very simple, only to the point information is they're like unlike an email mein to we write the body, we write the structure, we write the closing. Memos mein nothing. Memos mein you write whatever is your concern, whatever is the information, whatever is needed. Uske aage piche you don't have to write anything else, right? So this is what memorandum is all about. Coming to the basic format of a memo. What is the basic format of a memo? Let's see. I'll tell you. Now, jaisa maine aapko bataya, the memorandum is a postcard size thing. It's a square thing which has a heading upper called memorandum, right? You all can Google the same and can find it out how the memorandum looks like. But yes, it may be different from one office to another office, so do not get confused, right? So it will have the heading called memorandum. It have the recipient name and address. Example, aap kisko bhejna chahte, you want to send the all employees of education department, right? So to all employees, to all faculties of education department, ye hamara address rahega. And the writer name means whosoever is sending from Shweta. Says Shweta, you write Singh?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Like
yes, ma'am.
Okay. From Shweta Singh, like whosoever. Shweta is one of the faculty in Amity. So if Shweta is sending some information to her faculties in the education department, so she will write to all the faculties of AIE, and then she will write her name, as in from so and so. And if she is sending a memo from the department's end, so she will write the department name that she belongs to, right? And then additional recipient, if you feel that the information should not only go to one office, the information should go to the other, AIB mein bhi chala jaye, ASEC mein bhi chala jaye, yahan bhi chala jaye, wahan bhi chala jaye, so you will write unke bhi name to all the employees of ASEC or XYZ, right? You will write the date, you will write the subject line very crisp, launch of new course or additional course or introduction to blah blah blah, right? A very crisp subject line, and then you will write it in points that what exactly do you wish the people to know, what information you want to circulate there. So you will write the circulate, the information that you have written there, and then you will proofread. Proofread karna zaruri isliye hota hai because you never know, you may have mistakenly written something else and that should not be written, or by mistake you wrote this, you did this, that. So which is why a proofread is very important, because that memo is not going to one person. The memo is going to almost all the faculty, so it should be correctly proofread by you or by anyone, right? So is tarike ka hota hai memo. Okay, see. Any doubts? Let me know.
No, ma'am.
Okay, now coming to circulars, hain ke aapke course mein. Yeah, hai circular. Okay, chalo. Let's do the circulars now. Ravi? Ravi?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. What are you doing right now?
Nothing.
Nothing? You're not listening to the session?
No, ma'am.
You're not listening. Yeah, very bad. Sun rahe the? Alia, you are back. Where were you?
Ma'am, I'm here only.
Now better, you were on hold. Were you listening to the session?
Yes, ma'am. I was.
Achha.
I was not on hold, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Okay, Ravi, then why don't you read this for us, the circulars? Thodi thodi neend aa rahi hai?
Neend?
Yeah? Nahi aa rahi?
Ma'am, 2 ghante class hongi to aayegi nahi ma'am.
Aayegi? Wo lag raha tha aap jaise bol rahe, yes ma'am. It seemed that you were suddenly, somebody woke you up. To 2 ghante ki class mein 12 मिनट्स के ब्रेक में क्या किया आपने? What did you do in that break, Ravi?
मैम सोने के तो लेकिन नींद ही नहीं आया मुझे.
नींद नहीं आई? तो रात में क्या करेंगे अगर अभी सो जाएंगे तो आप?
सोएंगे मैम रात में.
जी, चलिए. Ravi, read this for us, circulars. Come on and wake up quickly. Yeah.
Circular is essentially a letter of connecting some important information that is distributed to a large numbers of people. Say, for example, you have to invite the entire department for a meeting, or update the dress policy for the whole office. A culture will be the best mode of communication for this process.
Read. Why did you stop, Ravi? Read. I'll tell you where to stop. You keep reading.
Also, find the use and advancing tools. They can content making information. You have the wide distribution range, be it for the interdepartmental communication, investing for the even personal reasons of. Curricular must always reach a large number of components. This is one its main features. Main feature.
Again, let's you stop.
Continue, ma'am.
Ji, bilkul.
Okay, ma'am. Let us take a look at some of the advantages of a curricular. It is very simple and effective way of communication, since of patience and written is very little chance of miscommunication. Second, it is also quite inspect. It is also quite of inspective. It is the cost effective way of communication. Third, culture. Circular also a time of saving method. It reach a large numbers of people in very limited times of effort. They are advancing of making tools as very well. They can help create a new market, educated people about the product of services and also increase customer confidence in the company and the product.
Thank you, Ravi. Now please be very attentive. Huh? I can ask anyone any questions. Now we are talking about circulars. You all know what circulars are. Circulars kya hote hain? See, any information that probably my department wish to circulate among all the faculty, right? So it's a paper which has, it's a letter or a paper which has all the relevant information and which is being circulated to a large number of people, right? So I'm taking small example of the department itself, right? So it's a circular which says that, all right, from tomorrow, everyone have to report at 9:30 in the college, right? So this is the circular. Now this is the circular being circulated among all the faculties of Amity University, all 300-350 faculties of Amity University, right? Now the circulars are basically used for the advertising tool also. If I want to advertise anything, maybe my product, so I will write a proposal, I will write a letter, I will write an application kind, and I will circulate it in across everyone with the brochure. So probably it is also, it can be used as the advertising tool. It has various informations. Maine aapko example diya ki aap hamara punching time, agar biometric pe time change ho raha hai. So wo bhi circular will go to all the department, will go to all the faculties for any kind of information that you want everyone to know about it. So second example hai for the product that you want to advertise for. So wo bhi circular ki tarah you can send it to everyone, jisko hum insertions bhi bolte hain na, paper insertions mein bhi circulars you keep on sending the circulars to so many people. That is how you promote your business, right? So they can contain marketing information, why distribution range, blah 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 blah, and we all know that it reached to the large number of correspondents. Now Ravi read about the basic features, that there are certain advantages of circulars. So he said that circulars are very simple, correct, very effective way of communication. When you're sending a circular to so many people, or itne log circular pe sign karte hain hamare abhi, when we get a circular within the department or somewhere from other departments, we have to sign that circular. You know why we have to sign? So that it gives the person can always go through and say, did you read the news or not? So it is a kind of authenticity that you have read the news and you are signing the same, so that it clearly gives the impact that you know what is written in that circular. Yahan tak samajh mein aa raha hai everyone? If you think that I'm going too fast, please stop me. Do you all understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
Rohit, Shraddha, Alia, Alisha.
Yes, ma'am.
Rohit, any time, any kind of disconnect, please stop me.
Sure, ma'am.
Okay. Right. So it is quite inexpensive. A sheet of paper won't be very expensive, very cost effective way of communication. Circulars are also very time saving method. Main kisi ko mail karu, I don't know whether the person will send see the mail or not, but if I'm sending a circular to so many people, everyone is signing, I know ki is department mein 10 faculty hai, to 10 no sign kiya hai, so I know everyone has seen what is written in the circular. So it is kind of when you can doubly check the same, right? And very limited time and effort lagta hai circulars mein. You just have to type the message and have to circulate to so many people. And the great advertising and marketing tool, jaisa aapne bataya, that you educate people about the services that you're offering. So circulars mein ye bhi hota na, when you have the pamphlet, you write all the features, you write the specifications, and you circulate it to everyone, so everyone knows that there's something like this which has so many specifications, so much things, so many things, and all these things, right? So these are circulars. There is a sample of the same. Let's see how it looks like. Okay, this looks like, it looks like here. Circular number isliye likha jata hai that tomorrow somebody says, I don't know, I did not read what is there in the circular. Then somebody will tell you, okay, open circular number 12, and then you find it out in the file. Acha, circular number 12 pe maine sign kiya tha, which means I know the news, but I did not, but I don't remember. So that is the circular number. Read revised working hours or any implementation of course, new course, could be anything, the subject. And whosoever it is going. Okay? Too much for today?
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Why were you all not telling me initially? Had I not asked this question, you would all have been sitting quietly? I asked you this, so you all said yes, but you all did not tell me on your own that, ma'am, can we stop the session? Can we continue it in the next class? Why did you not tell me this? तो अभी तक जो पढ़ाया इज इट क्लियर डू यू हैव एनीथिंग एनी डाउट्स एनीथिंग दैट यू विश टू आस्क प्लीज आस्क
मैम इट्स ऑल क्लियर टू मी
यस मैम
ठीक है ओके सो ये सर्कुलर का फॉर्मेट था फटाफट देख लीजिए सर्कुलर नंबर इन एवरीथिंग This is the body of the circular. That's where you write all the information. This is where you write all the information and then the name of the person who is sending the same. Okay. Okay, we'll stop here from circulars. But we'll just stop. Okay. We'll continue the further session in the next class. Ravi, you can mute your mic. Okay. So students, wherever you feel it's too much to absorb because we have 27 classes and I'm not in a hurry to finish the course, it's okay. But for me, this is important. It is important for me that everyone who is sitting here with me, all six students should understand everything because you know, you have already cleared the examination. You know how is the evaluation process. You know the gravity of everything. So which is why I keep telling you, अगर लग रहा है बहुत ज़्यादा हो रहा है तो stop me then and there and say, ma'am, can we discuss this in the next class? And I have no problems, right? Don't push yourself. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Chalo. All right. We'll end this class here, and. I will upload the notes on Teams. Abhi, I'm not doing it. Let me finish one or two modules and then I will upload the same on Teams. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
What is left today? One second, notices is over. Okay. Next class, hopefully we'll do the agenda. We'll the agenda and Shweta please do what I said
okay ma'am
take the syllabus print out or take it with you highlight it that these are the things that we did because I'm going to pick up the randomly the modules whatever I have it with me so I'll randomly take it and then we'll see what is missing and what is not okay
okay ma'am
and everyone please make your own notes that's very important ठीक है मेक योर ओन नोट्स डू नॉट कंप्लीटली रिलाय अपॉन व्हाट इज बीइंग टॉट व्हेन यू सी द सिलेबस लास्ट में यू विल फाइंड इट आउट द रेफरेंसेस आर वेल मेंशन सो यू मे टेक द नोट्स फ्रॉम द रेफरेंसेस एंड यू नो हाउ इट इज राइट देयर विल बी लॉट ऑफ इवैल्यूएशंस आल्सो यू सी द सिलेबस नीचे देखो सिलेबस में अगर इफ यू हैव द सिलेबस विद यू सो सी इट इन द सिलेबस कैसे हो आज ओके द सिलेबस इज हियर या सो इवैल्यूएशन का फटाफट आप लोग देख लीजिए check your syllabus whenever you have time abhi I'm just telling it to you there'll be a quiz for 10 marks there'll be the assignment for 10 marks group presentation for 15 marks discussion group discussion is for 10 marks attendance is for 5 marks and your end term examination was of 50 marks yes so this will be your assessment parameters theek hai And I think the same way it was in the last class also. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yes.
ऑनलाइन या ऑफलाइन मैम?
बच्चे 17 से आई थिंक यू ऑल हैव टू कम एज पर द ईमेल. स्टूडेंट्स हैव टू रिपोर्ट बाय 17th आई गेस. श्वेता क्या है, व्हाट इज द इन्फो, है ना?
प्रॉपर फिजिकल मोड फ्रॉम 17.
हाँ, इवन आई हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस रवि, इवन आई हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस कि 17 से इट विल बी ऑफलाइन. But I don't know the latest news. हाँ रवि,
मेरा कहना था कि मैम सेकंड ईयर में जो एग्जाम होगा वो ऑफलाइन मोड में होगा या ऑनलाइन में?
रवि रवि रवि, अगर ऑफलाइन आओगे तो ऑफलाइन ही होगा ना.
ओके मैम,
है ना, ऑफलाइन अगर आप आओगे तो ऑफलाइन होगा. अभी तक ये उसलिए हो रहा था ऑनलाइन बिकॉज थिंग्स वर हैपनिंग ऑन द वर्चुअल प्लेटफॉर्म. नाउ बिकॉज यू ऑल विल कम सो एवरीथिंग विल बी हियर. नाउ आई हैव माई टू फ्रेंड्स हु लेफ्ट द सेशन. व्हाई भाई? श्रद्धा एंड विधि बोथ आर नॉट हियर.
यस मैम, बिकॉज द डेली डाटा हैज बीन यूज्ड, दैट्स व्हाई.
2 hours की क्लास में द डेटा हैज बीन यूज्ड?
No, ma'am. Morning से क्लास थी ना आज उनकी, that's why.
फिर Wi-Fi is best. Get a Wi-Fi. चलो अब तो खैर offline होगा, so things will not be that way.
Ma'am, mine also 90% data is used.
Get a Wi-Fi. No, I know, I know. होता है बेटा. और इसीलिए कैमरा भी शायद आप लोग नहीं ऑन करते हो. Is that the reason?
Yes, ma'am.
Data
yes,
consumption. Data consumption is more.
Yes, ma'am.
Chalo, take care. Okay, everyone, I'll see you in the next class with the agenda. Okay, agenda as in from the agenda. We have done the circulars. Now we'll continue with the agenda in the next class. Okay, thank you. Take care, everyone. I'll see you
thank
on
you.
Wednesday.
Thank Bye-bye. You.
Yep, thank you. Take care.